But honestly, I think when you grow up as other and you get constantly asked or looked at as why are you here, what brought you here, then you really have to think about your place in the world in a way that other people don't.
Yeah.
And the only way I could make sense of that was to think, I can, it's stories. It's only through stories that you can stand in my shoes and I can stand in yours.
Yeah, yeah.
And
yeah.
they are universal and they're without barrier and they're without race and class. That space, wherever that is, whether it's on this, on a stage or in a book, is where I can be accepted and I can feel the empathy of other people.
Have you played that game where you have a, you hold a card up to your forehead and it's got the name of a character on it and you have to find out who you are by how people react to you?
Yeah, yeah.
Well, I felt like I was doing that all the time in certain situations, whether it be choir or the youth theatre or in the shop or with my mom or on my own with my mates or whatever. The card always changed form. And I was just being me, but I had to interact with people to find out what was on the card for them. And then I had to be that. Sometimes it was, if I was out with my mates, it was just a nuisance. And sometimes, and so, and a lot of the time it was related to colour quite a lot. It was never blank. It was never just a grey, amorphous, you know, opaque thing that I could infuse my own character on. My character, who I am, was being stamped on me by reports or statistics or reactions at school or subjects. Or I see what you mean about there's that empty space in the middle where you think I could actually be anything.
Yeah.
Because outside my accent was one thing.
Yeah.
In the house it was a different thing. The different accent I was hearing.
When you suddenly realise that the thing that makes you different and stand out is also your salvation.
Yeah.
It's also where all your stories come from.